Let's walk through how to enter a CPD activity on your dashboard. If you have a certificate that includes a 9-digit activity ID, simply enter the number here. Your activity ID will populate all fields with related information, so you don't have to. If you don't have an activity ID, you can add your information manually. Let's say you want to enter a main Pro Plus group learning activity, such as a conference. You have 3 activity categories available. In this case, you'll choose group learning. Then indicate whether this is a certified or non-certified activity. You'll see your drop-down options change based on your previous selections to simplify the process for you. Next, choose your delivery format. A live in-person event or live webcast means something you watched in real time, so not a recording. Online self-study is also known as asynchronous learning. This involves content you can access on your own whenever it makes sense for you. This advanced search feature lets you find a specific event by title, the 9-digit session ID, city, or activity date. It's easy to find the activity even with minimal information available. Find your activity and then click Select. Don't see your activity? Click on this Don't See Your Activity button and manually fill in your details. Related information will be pre-populated for you in the next step. For many submissions, you'll need to complete an impact assessment questionnaire. This will allow you to demonstrate how an activity affected your practice, and it will give you the chance to report any bias you may have perceived. Here's another example. Let's say you participated in a practice audit with a colleague. Select Add a CPD activity. You would enter this activity in the assessment category. Then click Certified. Next, you'll choose the activity type and click Continue. Please make sure you read the instructions carefully before proceeding. This activity allows you to claim 6 certified credits per form. These guides help you formulate your answer and best describe the impact of your activity. At any time, you can click Send to Holding Area to save your progress. This lets you complete the process over multiple sessions. Here's how to upload a document to show any proof needed for your participation in an activity. Click this Select button and then select the file you want to upload. Complete all questions and then click Submit. You'll see this pop-up. From here, you can decide what you want to do next. Should you want a walkthrough of other Maine Pro Plus features, you can find additional tutorial videos on the Maine Pro Plus resources and our frequently asked questions pages on the Maine Pro Plus section of the CFPC website. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. We hope you find it helpful when you're entering your CPD activities.